Welcome guys, in this video we are going to discuss the lead placement and what are the various types of leads we have in ECG. So when it comes to leads in ECG, there are two types. One is called as the limb leads and second is the chest leads. Now chest lead is very easy to appreciate. They can be from V1 to V6 and in some times we can use the V7, V8 and V9 also. We will discuss that. When it comes to the limb lead can be of two types. One is called as bipolar and second is called as unipolar. The bipolar ones are the first, second and the third standard leads. These are the bipolar. When it comes to unipolar, they are the AVR, AVL and AVF. These unipolar leads which we are discussing here, they are also called as augmented leads. Augmented leads, that is why A word is there, A for augmentation. Yes. So these are the various leads we have. Now how to place them? So when it comes to the chest lead placement, that is important to understand. See, this is the right side and this is the left side. We start from the fourth intercostal space on the right side in the parasternal line. This is the parasternal line. So you will place the V1 here in the fourth intercostal space, the parasternal line. Then we are going to place the V2 in the same fourth intercostal space, but on the left side. Then you are going to place the V4 first, not the V3. V4 you are going to place where? You are going to place in the fifth intercostal space in the mid clavicular line. Then once you have placed the V4, then what you are going to do is V2 to V4 in the midway you are going to place the V3. Wherever is the midpoint, you are going to place V3 there. Then the V5, V6, we all are going to place in the fifth intercostal space, the mid clavicular line, the anterior axillary line, the mid axillary line. This is how we are going to place the chest leads. But if you are placing the V7, V8 and V9 that we use for the posterior wall MI, if you want to detect that, then they are going to be placed here in the fifth intercostal space only on the left side in the posterior axillary line, in the mid scapular line and in the paravertebral line. Yes. Right. So this is how we are going to place the various leads of the ECG. Now once we know the placement, why we place the leads in such a way, because they give the view or they are taking the information from a particular site of the heart. They are called as contiguous leads. Contiguous leads means what? Say for example, if you talk about the, this is the heart representation. So if I draw like this, this is the left side and this is the right side. So I can say that this is the lateral wall of the heart, the left side lateral wall, right? So from this particular side, the leads which are taking the information, they are the first AVL, V5 and V6. So if there is any change in the lateral wall, if there is any change or any pathology in the lateral wall, we are going to see the changes in the first AVL, V5, V6. In the same way, V3 and V4, they are taking the information from the anterior sides, anterior wall of the left ventricle. Second, third AVF, they are taking the information from the inferior side. So inferior wall information is there in the second, third AVF. So the ECG leads, they work in a group. This group is called as contiguous leads. Second, third AVF, they are contiguous. V3, V4, contiguous. First AVL, V5, V6, contiguous, right? So the list is given here. If there is inferior wall MI, you are going to see changes here, lateral, anterior, septal. Yes. So this is how we have to go for the ECG interpretation. When it comes to the ischemia, they are going to occur in a particular territory, lateral wall MI, inferior wall MI, anterior wall MI. So you are going to see the changes in these groups of the leads of the ECG. This is the normal waveform of the ECG. You can see the first positive deflection is the P wave, then is the QRS wave, then is the T wave, and lastly is the U wave. These are the various waves which we have. When it comes to interval, we have three intervals, the PR interval, ST interval and the TB interval. You can easily appreciate and figure out that from where to where they are talking about, right? Yes. Thank you guys.